If you wanted to give someone directions, how would you go about it? Personally, as an English speaker, I'd use the terms forwards, backwards, left and right to guide the listener from their own perspective. For instance, if I wanted them to take this route, I'd say something like, turn left, then take the third right. This is the system almost all English speakers would probably use, and is what we call an egocentric or relative system. That is, it's based on and moves with the body, so individuals facing in opposite directions refer to the same object's location using different words, whether that be left or right. But such a system isn't universal. The Gugu Yimitir people, who live in Hopevale, in northeastern Australia, don't have words for left and right, but rather use a system of cardinal directions, north, south, east and west, for all such purposes. This is what we call a field-based or absolute system. The Gugu Yimitir words technically aren't the four directions we know in English. They're slightly offset by 15 degrees clockwise to reflect the physical geography of where they live. These people have been shown to have excellent spatial memories, being able to accurately keep track of the cardinal directions and distant landmarks, even having gone on long, winding walks with little visual reference of where they are. Other languages use what's known as an intrinsic system. This is where one object's position is defined in relation to some natural part of another. If you wanted to describe a tree that lies next to a building, you could only talk about it being in front of, to the side, or behind the house. Where in front of would be defined as on the side with the door, and not relative to where you, as an observer, are. Of these three systems, absolute languages have the most different types. We've discussed the Gugu Yimitir, who use rough cardinal directions to navigate. But there are far more ways to define your position relative to your environment. For instance, in the Manum language, which is spoken on an almost circular island, the four main words are inland, seawards, and right and left when facing the sea. Another common absolute system is found in the Yupno people. The Yupno live in the Yupno Valley, in the northeast of Papua New Guinea. Their valley is carved out by the Yupno River, which is fed into by a number of tributaries, each of which forms a little side valley. Their system of spatial understanding stems from these surroundings. Rather than the cardinals of Gugu Yimitir, or the land-sea axis of Manum, the Yupno use an uphill-downhill distinction, where all directions are defined as uphill, downhill, or across the hill. This distinction surfaces in a few different ways, such as in demonstratives. In English, we have four so-called demonstratives. These are the words this, that, these, and those, which are used to verbally point to a certain thing. To help distinguish what we're pointing to, these words encode a couple of features items may have. This and that denotes singular objects, while these and those are plural, denoting multiple objects. Additionally, the words indicate how far from the speaker the object is. This and these are proximal, indicating that the object or objects are close to the speaker. That and those, however, are distal, indicating objects further away from the speaker. Other languages make different distinctions. In Japanese, there are separate demonstratives for objects close to the speaker, objects close to the listener, and objects far away from both of them. Hausa adds an extra layer, using the same three of Japanese, but having an extra distinction of objects very far away from both people. Yupno demonstratives don't contrast number, but do make a three-way distinction in proximity. On top of this, medial and distal demonstratives distinguish whether what they're referring to is uphill, downhill, or across the hill. Motion verbs also make this distinction. Words which correspond to the English come, go, bring, and take each have three different roots, indicating whether the motion is uphill, downhill, or across the hill. These verbs are then able to combine with other verbs to show the direction of different motions. And it isn't just when describing space that the Yupno use this contrast. They extend it as well to time. For the Yupno, the past is downhill, while the future is uphill. They use phrases like the downhill year to mean last year, and the uphill year to mean next year. This is very similar to how in English we refer to the future as being ahead of us, and the past as being behind us. But instead of using English's egocentric system, the Yupno use their uphill-downhill system instead. All in all, the uphill-downhill distinction is ingrained very deeply into the Yupno language. But while this is all well and good when you're outside and can see the valley and feel the slope, what happens when you're inside? Much like anyone else, the Yupno prefer to build on flat ground, so inside their houses, there's little indication of where up and down actually are. In these spaces, you still need to be able to talk about movement and location. So, how's it done? Well, Yupno houses are built according to a very particular layout. They're long, roughly oval shapes, with a door at one end and a long fire pit running down the middle of the room. In the minds of the Yupno people, this layout is very similar to the larger valley outside. It's a long space, with the river running down the middle and exiting at the bottom, very much like the fire pit and door of the house. It's therefore possible to describe location in relation to this, with downhill terms being used to describe locations towards the door, i.e. down the conceptual valley, and uphill terms for locations away from the door. The Yupno do this even when the door actually faces up the external valley. They do still sometimes use the external setting as their point of reference, but this is a minority of the time, and use of the micro-world, as it's called, is far more common. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this slightly shorter than normal video. I have just recently finished and submitted my dissertation, so I haven't had the most time of late. Still, I think this was a very interesting little topic. So, until next time, thank you for watching.